Okay guys, here we go for another trip on Euro Truck Simulator 2. This is the latest version we've got. We have the Vive La France downloadable content installed. We've also got the Mario map installed. Now this is where we are today. We're in Cuesta Lipan in Argentina, and we've got a trip that's going to go through the mountains and take us up to Villanueva. And it's, I think it's 18 tons of cheese. What a, can't I think any better to do than to drive 18 tons of cheese through the mountains. Anyway, this is the, as I say, the Mario map. That's exactly where we are. That's Brazil. Of course, you've got the South America map. The additional thing you've got in the latest version of this map is this little bit here, which is actually Canada. It's only a small area. There's the UK, you've got Iceland and the Faroe Isles, and then of course you have the rest of the Russia map all over here. So anyway, we won't hang about any longer. We've got some interesting driving to do. Now the other thing to mention is I've got I think it's called Brutal Engines or something like that in the trucks. So it's an engine mod that I've got installed. Now I think the truck that I'm driving has got like a 2000 horsepower engine. Now it makes a terrible racket, so it does, but I'll tell you one thing, it's good for getting up these hills. Let's see how we go and let's get to some driving. Right, so there's our cheese. Now, I take it we're going left here. What time of day is it? It's 7:35 a.m. in the morning. You hear the noise of these engines, you hear this. Now, where the hell are we getting out of here? Oh aye, we're actually in, we're in IKEA's car park, I think it is. I think that's where we picked this cheese up from. I think it is. Yeah, that's it. That's where we get out. Round here. I think we're going out the entrance, but it doesn't matter. Right, so now, why is that map showing that we're going two directions here, by the way? That's a bit crazy. GPS is going a bit mental. It's showing me either go left or right. Now if we go right, why is it showing go left as well? I'm curious to find out why. Must be some sort of bug. Right. Right, zoom in the map. Ah, wait a minute, that's what's wrong. I've accidentally put a bloody waypoint in the map. That's what I've done. Right, hang on a minute. Get rid of that. Right, we've got rid of the waypoint. That's what the mistake was. It's my fault, as usual. Right, so now we're definitely going right. Okay for fuel, and we've got 740 miles to go. Well, this will be interesting. This beast just wants to go, it just wants to tear the road up, so it does. But this kind of engine is way more powerful than you actually need, but it certainly helps getting up these mountain roads, as you'll soon find out. Another thing we have installed is there's a weather mod installed, so you can see you've got misty mornings. You've got sort of mist hanging around in the valleys. It's actually quite a good weather mod. Now, one thing to mention as well is I've also got, this is a Mario Map 12.1, the latest version. I've got the traffic mod installed with it as well. Now, I think it's on normal settings. There's two different files in the traffic mod. I need to go down a gear here. And I've got it on a normal setting. Now what I have noticed is it does cause a bit of a loss of frame rate in certain places. I don't know whether that's a bug or whether that's actually the after effects of just installing the mod. It does occasionally offer the odd drop in frame rate. I think we might want to get past this guy up ahead here, he might hold us back. Now the problem with this road, I've driven it before, the problem is the speed that you're limited to going through these switchbacks, and of course the rest stops that are available, there aren't many. So you've got to get a move on when you can. We're starting to climb. Right, I'm going to go past him. Back end come off the road there. Well, there's where we've just came down in the bottom right. Stuck here. Now with this weather mod, in this part of the world you usually get rain and thunderstorms at some point during the day. traffic building up behind us. But we've really got to start pushing it. Thing you can meet on one of these switchbacks is another truck coming the opposite direction, because your back end's going to cut across this corner. Good that we're actually driving through this in daylight. Most of the time I've driven this route has been night time. I think we're going to do most of this section in daylight. But the once we've done this climb and descent, we've then got another one once we're going to our destination, and that'll probably be during the night. But we're going to have to take a rest stop at some point anyway. Hopefully we can get through this section first, but we can only do that by keeping the pace up. Now with a normal truck with a normal engine, you're always struggling to get through here. Cannot take your eye off the ball for a second on this route. guy behind us is determined to get past us. Here's the, this is a section I call the corkscrew. We reach the top of the climb here. This road just goes round and round and round till it gets to the top and across the bridge. And this is a tight spot. This guy in the car's gonna try and pass us here. Something else coming as well. Made it through there. Now we need to push on. to say, but difficult to say whether the weather's changing or not. It looks as if there's sort of blue sky up above. Clouds might be gathering. But we definitely need to keep pushing through this area here. Got to try and make the rest stop when we get there. Now we've got a big drop and a big loss in frame there. That froze. Now I never got that in the game until I added that traffic mod, and that's the sort of thing I'm talking about, where it freezes up. And it's not just so much to do with the trees and everything that's round about, it just didn't happen without that mod installed. I think I'm going to just take that one out after this video. I don't like the after effects you get with it. Now, let's check. We've got 5 hours to go before we need to take a rest stop now. I think this is the motel. Is this the motel? No, it's not. It's a fuel stop. We don't need to take anything here, but to get to the next one, we've got to go. Because now we're coming to another big string of spaghetti on the GPS. Speed here. So we've done a climb, now we're doing the big descent. Excuse me. And there's a road down there. Big drop to go. I can't even remember where the next rest stop is, but I just know that we're going to struggle to get there. Because there's nothing worse than trying to drive this road when your driver's falling asleep. You end up just driving straight down the mountain. Straight over the edge. No barriers in this section, which seems crazy. Everything goes down to our left. Now that Vive la France downloadable content that I've got installed, the last trip that I took to get down to Cuesta Lipan was a trip that took me right through the heart of France, right through to Spain, eventually down to Casablanca, and then had to get a connection from there over to Argentina. And driving through France, it was basically straight down the motorway all the way through central France. So apart from the only change that you notice is that it has the French toll gate system, which some of the gates are fully automatic. As you approach them, you have to approach at a certain speed so that you don't crash into the barrier, but that's the only thing I really noticed. I never noticed a really great deal of difference on the map, but a lot more exploring on it needs to be done, definitely. But there are, I think, about 12 different cities, 12 new cities in France, and also different companies. Supposed to be a change in the environment as well, different foliage and flora and stuff like that, but again, I didn't get a chance to see much. Just let this bus go past. Now there's the weather has taken a turn, we're heading into a storm. Now I can see a fuel station on the GPS, but that one that I think it might be the one that's awkward to get to. Again, I can't remember, but it's quite a way away yet. This weather mod, you can hear the rain bouncing off the windscreen. Now he's bottled out of it. He thought about it and then he decided against it. What time is it? 3:30 in the afternoon, so it's getting dark with this storm moving in. Too quick, need to get the anchors on. Don't know whether that's a bus or a truck behind me. It's usually a bus that tries to overtake you. I think that's only fuel anyway. I don't know whether it's a rest stop. I think it's only fuel. Somebody's chickened out again. It's a truck. We'll let him go past. Now let's have a check at our stats. We've got a rest stop in 2 hours. This is always the problem in this part of the map, because you just cannot get through this area at any great speed. Now, that looks like a rest stop there. I see something on the map. The question is how easy it is to get to it, and remembering how to get to the bloody thing. It might be the one where you have to go off-road to get to it. I'm not sure. It might be the hotel. I know there is a hotel somewhere on it. Oh, that was tight. Okay, we're pushing it just a bit too hard. This is a fuel station. There's no rest stop in there. Oh, these speed humps in the middle of nowhere. Now we do have to take a rest stop. Yeah, this is a hotel. Right, so we'll take a rest stop here, and it's going to be middle of the night when we get back on the road. I know what I'm going to do. I'm just going to leave the trailer here. Right, so get the engine off. What time is that? 17:42, so it's going to be like 2, 3 in the morning. Let me start again. Hopefully the weather's cleared. There we go, it's 2:44 AM, so again, that'll let us see the final section of this map in daylight. Let's go pick up the trailer. Get the wipers off. Dawn's just beginning to break. Now he's decided against it again. What's that, 390 miles to go? Well, we're going to struggle to do that without another rest stop. What day is this? Tuesday. Tuesday at 3 AM. We have to get there for at 10 minutes past 5 at the latest. So we can't take another rest stop, or we won't get there in time. You're always going to struggle on this particular part of the map, especially driving through these mountains, to actually get a delivery done in time. Now, I struggled with a normal truck, with a normal engine. I was always struggling to get there in time. Very often I was late. Got to keep pushing it, but be careful, because you're going to end up going off the road if you push it at the wrong time. I can tell straight away we're not going to make this in time. Because the speed we're going at, just does, you know, we're just not going to make up the mileage at these kind of speeds, especially when we hit the climb and the switchback that's still to come. This guy. Clearing sun coming through the valley. Water to go through, hopefully staying in the road. Thank you. twitchy, going too fast. Through more water. It's quite eerie up ahead with the sun glinting through the gap in the mountains. Still over 300 miles to go. I still don't think we're going to make this at all. Not in time, I don't think. Got to pull our way out. Now, the trip's got 7 hours to go, and we're showing that we need to take a rest stop in 7 hours, so it's on the borderline. Also got the US truck mod installed as well, that is optional for the Mario map. That's why you'll have seen some American trucks as we've been driving. Right, now, this is the next challenging stage of this trip, the trip up and over to our destination in Villanueva. Once we get out of town, you can see we've got quite a bit of traffic now. 5 minutes to six in the morning. We've got rush hour beginning. We can hardly see with this sun in our eyes. This is going to be no good to us at all, this, getting stuck behind traffic. See, this is now a desert area, high up in the mountains. That's just where we came from, bottom left. I had to get past him. This is where we're up on the top of a what looks like a plateau, a desert plateau. We we've no time to admire the scenery, we need to keep moving. 240 miles still to go. And there's another tough section still to come before we get there. Weather's closed in again. Bus drivers in this part of the world don't give a shit. Paso Stelvio. Miles to go. I think we'll be falling asleep by the time we get to where we're going, or we'll be almost asleep before we get there. I've missed a turn there, I've missed a bloody turn. This road goes nowhere. AI people don't pay any attention to the traffic lights at all, just walk out into the road and you run them over. Really closed in. It's only 9 a.m. in the morning. Well, this is where the final leg starts here. say, that was a crack of thunder. This is a problem you've got with the AI going up these tight inclines. Miles to go. This is going to seem like the longest 124 miles in Eurotruck when you're driving on this road. Another truck up ahead, just made this corner. We need to get past him as well. This is a tight bend. Still 49 miles to go, and fatigue has set in. why it's still 19 miles an hour speed limit in this part of the road. Well, there's our destination up ahead. I knew it was going to be a struggle to make it in time. That wasn't a good move. Right, this is usually a tight corner into this little village. Get there somehow. And we're okay provided we don't meet anything coming the other way. Villanueva. So our cheese has arrived. And it's not a nice day. Zoom in a bit to see where we're going. Right, now. Well, there's a parking spot there. And we've just made it in time. Excellent, we did. And we are just short of level 32, so that concludes our trip from Cuesta Lipan to Villanueva with 18 tons of cheese, and we got there in one piece. So we will see you again sometime, no doubt.